Hey, what up? Big Daddy here, Duke Southern Grill. Tonight we're chefing up curry goat, coconut rice, sweet plantains, steamed carrots, and cocoa bread. Y'all know y'all want to see this video. That's what's up. Be easy, subscribe. Big Daddy here, Duke Southern Grill. Today, we're cooking curry goat, Jamaican curry goat, coconut rice, plantains, sweet plantains, and I'm gonna do a little bit of steamed carrots today for the vegetable. I said Jamaican curry goat because there's a difference in curry. There's Jamaican, of course, which is West Indian, but even in those different islands, the curry flavor is a little different. You know, you got Trinidad, even East Indians have their own type of curry. So, today, Jamaican. I have 4.5 to 5 pounds of goat. I got it divided actually because I've already gone over to my next step. I'll explain that in a minute. So in here, I really only have about 2.5 pounds or so. So, you wanna season it. Salt and pepper to taste, or use your curry powder and season it with that and let it stand overnight or for at least a couple of hours. I use curry powder. I'm not going to give you my curry powder recipe. There's recipes out there that you can search up if you want to make your own, or a good one off the shelf is what's the name of that one that you like?
I think Grace.
Grace, right? Yeah, I believe so. So check that one out. I have used that in the past and it's pretty good, you know. Try to get one that doesn't have a lot of salt. The cheaper ones are high in salt. You don't want those, so just stay away from those if you're buying it. Alright, so marinated goat meat. You want to make sure before you do that though, you want to wash it. Some people even wash it down with a little bit of vinegar. It can be gamey to those who are not used to it, but let me tell you, this is a very flavorful meat. Out of all of your meat, if you really want to compare it, it has a more nutritional value, less fat. I mean, it's awesome. It's really good. So, with that being said what we're doing, said how we started this out, what you want to do is start sauteing this up because you want it to brown. So, I have let me say 3 tablespoons of oil. And you're gonna saute these up. For those who watch the oxtail video, same process. Put these up in here so they get brown. And then we'll move on to the next step. I'll be doing another batch. But when I come back, we'll show y'all what to do next. All right, we're back. That's what the goat should look like once it's brown. This is the basis with this curry goodness. So let's just, let's say y'all only working with 3 pounds. All right, I told you I'm working with more than that. So let's say 3 pounds. In this pot right here, I have 2 cloves of minced garlic, 1 minced Scotch bonnet pepper. You can omit that if you don't want a lot of heat, or if you want to tone it down a little, just score it a couple times with a knife and throw it in there whole. 1 medium onion, a couple of scallions, 3 or 4 scallions, chopped. A tablespoon of tomato paste, 5 tablespoons of your curry powder. Remember, if you're buying it, buy the good stuff, not the cheap stuff. And that's about it. That is about it. You want to cook this up? That spice. I'm going to cook this up for about 3 or 4 minutes. Then we're gonna get this in the pot. Everybody sees it. So we got that up in the pot. I'm gonna let that simmer for a minute, and then I'm only gonna add water just until it comes up above the curry. I mean, the goat. All right, y'all be easy. All right, we back. This has come to a boil. I turned it down. It's gonna simmer for about an hour or so. The smaller pieces, I'm gonna check it in about an hour. I feel safer that way. You don't want to overcook it because it'll shred up on you. Larger pieces could cook for about 2 to 2.5 hours. So if you end up buying the same size pieces of goat that you've seen in this video, just check it after an hour. But experience is telling me it's gonna cook for about an hour and a half. It's gonna simmer in the spot for that long. So I'm gonna cover that up and then we're gonna get into the coconut rice. Be easy. All right, coconut rice, real simple. I'm gonna get y'all the basics. As y'all get accustomed to making it, y'all tweak it how y'all wanna tweak it. So, 1.5 cups of water or stock. Use stock. Trust me, it flavors the rice completely different. But for those who don't want to use stock, water. For y'all vegans out there, they do have that vegan stock. I'm sure y'all already know that. So y'all could use that too. So 1.5 cups of water, salt and pepper to taste, a little bit of garlic, a little bit of onion powder. Cup of rice, coconut milk, 1/2 cup. Let it do its thing. 30 minutes, you got coconut rice. That's the basics. Baby girls, I leave anything out that they gonna need to know. I don't think so, right? I mean,
make sure you add the rice once your water has rapidly boiled.
Oh, come on, you coming at them like that. Okay, so let's get real professional with it. So, you're gonna bring your water to a boil, and once it boils, you're gonna add your rice. You're gonna gently stir, and once it comes back to a boil, you're gonna cover and turn it down and simmer for about 30 minutes.
Perfect.
Yo, that's coconut rice. Y'all be easy. All right, y'all, welcome back. So we're doing sweet plantains. So this recipe is simple. You need about 3 large plantains, or the sort of in half plantains. So I got Colombian sweet bananas. I have it like that. These are smaller, so I'm using 6 of these. So just 6 of these are 3 large yellow plantains. You don't want the green ones for the sweet, you know, banana recipe. Slice those up. For those who haven't sliced a plantain or opened one up, it's a little bit different than the banana, so I'm gonna show y'all in a minute. But I'm gonna slice them up, have a little bit of brown sugar, toss them up. I say about 1/4 cup of brown sugar. You have a few tablespoons of oil in your pan heating up in my black skillet pan. That's not ready yet, so I'm gonna have to actually come back to drop those. I'm gonna show y'all. You don't wanna cut too deep into the peel, because then you'll actually cut the banana on the inside. And these peels are a lot thicker than your average banana. You just want to make sure that you don't break the banana. If you do, who will? I'm at home. So if I break the banana, my family can't say nothing. But, you know, you're having catered events and stuff like that. A lot of times your client, you know, they see a picture or image of something. They want exactly what's on that image. So you don't want to break up a banana. I cut them kind of thick, about 1/2 inch. You need to cut them at an angle, just like that. Now, I gotta wait. Well, let me toss this with the other ones. There you go, that's how that look. You gonna lay them in the pan. Well, I'll show y'all when I come back. Y'all be easy. All right, pan nice and hot. Oil it nice and hot. Plantains are dry. So you just want to arrange them like that. They're going to cook for about 2 or 3 minutes on each side till they're nice golden brown and those sugars would have caramelized. You want to cook these on medium and be cautious. Don't walk away from this right here. Like I said, it's only 2 or 3 minutes on each side because they will burn. Remember, it's sugar, right? That's what sugar does with heat. So just stay in the kitchen, twiddle your thumbs, talk to whoever in your house, and you, I don't know, fuck yourself. Alright, be easy.
And this is what the sweet plantains look like when they're flipped. See how the sugar is caramelized?
Yo, I'm loving y'all. I'm loving this. Another video, another day, another good dinner. Y'all hungry? How many of y'all coming over to eat? Here you go. Everything is nice. This goat is fork tender. That's the way you want it. But yet and still, it is on the bone. I had a camera issue. So, camera died. And I wasn't able to film a step that is kind of important. If you want potatoes in this, 2 cups of potatoes, diced, put it in there about the last half hour of cooking or so. If you want to thicken this, there's thickeners, or you can just do it the simplified way. Take about a half a cup of that hot broth you got right there. Put it in a bowl, not a glass bowl, people, all right? 2 tablespoons of flour, fork, mix that up till it's nice and creamy. Pour it in there, stir it in. Wait about another 15 minutes or so, and it'll thicken that up just a little bit. But remember, this is not gravies. You know, so you don't want it that thick. But these potatoes actually thicken it up just enough. Sweet plantains, coconut rice, Big Daddy and vegetables. I cut those carrots and the spares, steamed them a little bit, salt and pepper to taste. We did the cocoa bread. Hey yo, for y'all who want to see that video, go to YouTube, find my page, subscribe. That way every time I submit a video, y'all get it with the coconut bread recipe, and that whole video is up there. Yo, it's been real. Love y'all. Be easy.